Welcome back to PH.d TV, and today I'm going to be a little controversial. I'm going to talk about what I truly do believe are the most overrated Disney films. And I do want to go ahead and put out that these do not mean that these are bad films, because Disney very seldomly puts out bad films. They have, but that's not to say that what I'm choosing is... Actually, this is to say that these are well-made films. I just don't think they're as good as people make them out to be. There's aspects that are good about them, and there's aspects of why I understand why people like them. But they're ones I also don't understand how they got the love they did in the beginning. Starting with number one, Toy Story 3 is very overrated to me.
I guess most outcome true. With it all.
Andy's going to college. Can you believe it? What are you gonna do with these old toys?
Losing you.
My nose.
Here it is.
Here's your arm.
Give me that. That's
Honey,
mine.
The mustache.
To infinity and beyond.
To reset your Buzz Lightyear, insert paperclip.
Rex, use your finger.
Did you fix Buzz?
Bitácora espacial.
Buzz Lightyear al rescate.
Oh no.
Now, hear me out. Love Toy Story. Great film. It was nominated for Best Picture. And it was a great send-off. But even back in the day, when it came out for the first time, and I didn't see it opening day. I saw it maybe a week or so after everyone said it was the best Toy Story. It was a great finale. It was this, that, the other. I went to see it. I liked it. But I also didn't see the hype that everyone was talking about. Maybe it got too hyped by the time I saw it. But here's another thing. I would think it would be a great... And honestly, my opinion may not have been on this list that it being overrated if they hadn't kept making the movies. If they had wrapped up Toy Story with the third movie and they were done, I'd say, you know what? It is a good last movie. If they had wrapped it up with the third movie and they never made another movie in the Toy Story franchise, I would absolutely agree that that was a great trilogy and that it ended in a less overrated way, but they kept making them, therefore leaving the emotional impact of the third movie
pointless
because it wasn't the end. And Buzz and Woody are in it. They're great as always. The voice acting is fantastic. The story is meaningful. I mean, it's a Toy Story movie. It's gonna be great. But it was also just another Toy Story movie to me. I don't think it did anything different to break the mold. It was just another great Pixar movie to me. Sorry. Now with my second choice, I'm not gonna lie, my wife is gonna be upset with this one, and so is my brother-in-law, I'm pretty sure. But I really don't care for Sword in the Stone.
Okay! Now it's up to the swords.
Swords? Swords? Oh no!
Why, you ugly little fool of... You better get it, or don't you dare come back!
Let me in, let me in! Somebody, please, please, let me in.
It's no use, boy. They've all gone to the tournament.
Oh, what'll I do? Case...
Look, boy, look. They're in the churchyard.
A sword. Oh, Archimedes, a sword.
Watch it, boy.
Have a sword.
Now, come on, quick. Let's get out of here.
I didn't watch it a lot growing up, and about a year or two ago, my wife wanted to watch it. I watched it with her. It did nothing for me. I know this one has a little bit more of a cult following. People like this one a lot, and I don't specifically know why. And again, this whole video is a, in my opinion, video. This is not a, this is fact, this is law. I'm not telling you that this is the way, but this movie has never done a thing for me. And I get the whole King Arthur thing. It's fun, and I think it's at Disney where they have the sword and you can actually try and pull it out, la-di-da. But aside from that, getting to that point in the movie, I thought was just ridiculous, and it's not my cup of tea, and I don't know why it is considered to be one of the greats. If you like it, let me know down below why I'm wrong, and if you have a point that really stands out to me, maybe I'll give it another shot because I know my wife would be happy to watch it again. And now this one's also another Pixar movie and one that my wife loves. And in fact, I watched this movie because my wife loves it. And she said it was one of her favorites. And I could see why it's one of her favorites. I actually do think it's a great movie. I think it's this, that, the other. I can see why people like it all over the place. But I don't see the reason why it probably won best. I think it did win best animated feature at the Oscars the year it came out. And I think the story, even though it has a great moral behind it, the moral of the story is good. But I really just don't think Brave does much.
No one knows how we came to this land. A land filled with magic and danger.
And there's my mother. She's in charge of every single day of my life.
Oh, Mom.
She just doesn't listen.
Each of the firstborn must compete for the hand of the fair maiden.
I'll be shooting for my own hand.
Curse this dress.
Don't you dare loose another arrow.
I want a spell that changes my fate.
Done.
What's the worst that can happen?
If you had the chance to change your fate, would you?
It's a fairy tale story. Mother, daughter don't get along. To learn the lesson of loving family members and understanding and trying to be empathetic with one another, with the mom turning into a bear. I mean, I get it, but it's very simple to me. It has its moments. It has the Scottish style, which I enjoy. I've seen Braveheart. I've seen this, that, the other. I like the culture. But Brave is just a hyper simple movie to me, where I like at least a little bit of thought process. But then again, it's a kid's movie. It's not supposed to be hyper complicated. So once again, this is just a me thing. I think Brave is fine, but I also think it's a little overrated. And with this next one, I can absolutely, absolutely see the comments already. If this video ever goes viral and people are gonna make fun of me and they're gonna say I'm this, that, and the other, and you'll see what I mean. I think Zootopia is overrated just by a fuzz. But I'll explain why I think that.
Zootopia, a gleaming city where animals of all breeds, predator and prey alike, live together in peace and harmony.
ZPD's first rabbit officer, Judy Hopps.
You ready to make the world a better place?
Yeah. What can you tell us about the animals that went savage? Are we safe?
This is priority one. Hops, parking duty.
Yeah. Sir, I'm not just some token bunny. Hello? I'm here to ask you some questions about a case.
Then they should have gotten a real cop to solve it.
You are under arrest.
For what? Hurting a few wings?
You are a key witness.
No, he is.
I have 36 hours left. We can only solve it together.
It's not about how badly you want something. It's about what you are capable of.
I am a real cop.
Never let them see that they get to you, you bunnies. So emotional.
We may be evolved, but deep down, we are still animals.
Quit it. You're gonna start a howl.
No matter what type of animal you are, change starts with you.
And again, I do like Zootopia. I think it's very good, and I understand how it is a, if we're just gonna break it down, it's a movie about race relations in the style to where kids can understand it metaphorically in the context of animals. And it's a police detective story, which is kind of nice. It kind of has that mouse detective vibe that Disney did years ago, and it's very clever. And coming from a guy who works in the car industry at this time, the DMV scene is priceless, and honestly, probably the best part of that movie of itself. But that same year, the movie Moana came out, and that movie has stood the test of time a lot better. And I hear people talking about Moana 20 times more, not actual science, but people talk about Moana 20 times more than they talk about Zootopia. And Zootopia also won the best animated feature when I was going full on for Moana. And again, none of these movies are bad. I just think they're overrated. And I think Zootopia is not as good as Moana. Technically, and I would even say factually, there's a better moral behind Zootopia, why it was made, the way it was done, and also what it was aiming for and did it very successfully. But in comparison to Moana, which came out that year, I do believe Zootopia got overblown, and I don't think it necessarily aged in terms of the general public's popularity as well as Moana did. So with that, Zootopia. And this next one, I can just go ahead and see people unsubscribing. I can just assume the comments are gonna be brutal. And I'm just gonna state it as fast as possible and hear me out. And you know what? Bring it. Let me know down in the comments how bad this is. If Robin Williams was not in Aladdin, would Aladdin really be as good as it is?
I think there's something written here.
Hey! 10,000 years will give you such a crick in the neck.
Genie, I wish for you to make me a prince.
If you were to take out Robin Williams and put a different voice actor in, would Aladdin really be all that good? The music would be great still, the story would be timeless, but let's be real, would Aladdin really be as big and bad as it is as a classic if Robin Williams had nothing to do with it? Really think about that. I'm gonna give you 5 seconds to think about that. What if Aladdin did not have Robin Williams? Did you think about it? Just let me know. That's really the only thing. I like Aladdin, I really do, but just imagine if Robin Williams wasn't involved. Would it really be that big and bad? With that being said, let me know, do you think that these are overrated? Do you think my opinions are wrong? I'm sure you do, let me know. I know I have some pretty bold hot takes, especially with that last one, but I wanna have healthy discussion and I wanna hear your opinions. I love opinions, everyone has them, and that's the whole fun part of things like this. So comment down below, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and as always, this has been PhD TV. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.